has separated us from God. In Isaiah 59 verse 2, it says, your sins have separated you from your God. So sin has kept us away from that abundant, fulfilling relationship that God had originally intended for every man and every woman whom he created. How then shall this gap be bridged? Jesus, the Savior who sets us free from the bondage of sin, who takes away our sin, was born in Bethlehem, and which is why we can call upon him to take away our sin even today. Jesus is our Savior. He enabled us to live a life of victory over sin. Jesus, the Savior, has broken the influence, the power of sin over our lives. And now we're no longer under law, but we are under grace. He saved us to live a life as a new creation right here on earth. But he also bought us our relationship back with God, that now, even if we die, we can continue to live with God into eternity if we have accepted Jesus into our life. So Jesus bought us freedom from sin, the power of sin, and even death. So Jesus is our Savior, and because of him, we have victory over sin. Jesus is also the Lamb of God. And Jesus became that sacrifice for us so that our sins can be forgiven. So God, this day, you know, as we come into the presence of God, we worship him and we say, you know, Father, we adore you, we love you. All of this is possible only because Jesus has taken our sins. Jesus has taken upon himself, and because of the shedding of his blood, we have forgiveness for our sins. So Jesus is the true Lamb of God. The beautiful thing about this Lamb of God is that he identified with us. God has extended grace upon grace to us through his Son, Jesus Christ. And so Jesus is that true Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. We're included in the world, so you and I included. He takes away the sins of the world. He is that sacrifice that God the Father accepted so readily. Jesus is also the Messiah, our deliverer. Jesus is that Messiah who came to deliver us. And today we might be here sitting thinking, yes, Jesus is the Messiah. He delivers me from sin. He restores my relationship with God. But, you know, I want to encourage us to walk in the fullness of what Jesus has come to do as the Messiah. So the Son of God, or the Messiah, was manifested, or he appeared, he came to earth. Why? For this purpose, that he may destroy the works of the devil. Jesus is the very image of God, or rather, Jesus reveals God the Father. Many of us have this question: look at Jesus, look at the life of Jesus, look at the heart of Jesus. Helps us understand the very nature of God, who God is. This is what we celebrate when we celebrate Christmas. Emmanuel, he is God with us. God loved us so much that he chose to come down to this world and walk among us. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. As we go about the festivities of Christmas and share the love of Jesus, and introduce Jesus to others, who do you really think he is? Who do you know him to be? Who do you say he is? It's very important for us to know this Jesus for who he really is.